Rumble Gaming Club Worst Pickup Episode 164.
164? It feels like forever since I've been here. It's like two or three episodes I haven't been here.
It has. It has been a little bit. Last week we had our friend Ryan on.
Yep.
That was cool.
That was good.
It was nice for him to drive. And what was the week before that? Oh, Jordan came over.
Yeah, Jordan with the Marty episode.
Yeah, very surprising. I invited Jordan over just now. But he has friends over.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys. I tried.
Sorry.
What can you do? So, we got a ton of stuff to get through. My basement is full of shit, but it's now it's filling up with shit that I haven't shown. So, I got to get to it. We got to get to it.
Yeah.
We're going to buzz right through it. For a dollar, first up, I found this Mario Kart Wii backpack.
I dig it. Does it have a spot for the Wii, or does it just say Mario Kart?
I think it just says Mario Kart. For a dollar, though?
Yeah, for a dollar.
Can't beat it.
Goes with your Pac-Man windbreaker.
And to go with a dollar thrifting theme, how about this Pokemon trading card binder?
See, now what we need to do is get this binder full of actual Pokemon cards, throw it in that backpack, throw on some gamer gear, and head down to the shop and trade with the kids.
Is that what they do?
I have no idea, maybe. We'll find out.
Just the other night, out thrifting late at night, right before they closed, and I couldn't believe I seen these board games. First of all, I've never heard of Lionheart, but it's from the creators of Risk.
Yeah,
I guess it's a, plays a lot like, chess.
Hmm.
But with a bunch of figurines.
Yeah.
It's called fucking Lionheart, so that's just cool away.
Yeah, fucking play it, man.
And the best board game I found, I've been looking for this forever, Weapons and Warriors Castle Combat Set, guys.
But the cannon shoots or attacks with super shot accuracy.
It does. This came out in 94, and me and my brothers had this, and we definitely fucked around with it, and just, we never actually played the game. You set it up and just fucking destroy shit, lose all the marbles, and just pretty much fight with each other over it.
Looks awesome.
It does look awesome. I looked at it. It appears that everything's in there. I didn't count everything out, but for $2.75 or whatever.
Yeah, like, okay. It's
a win-win either way.
Yeah, and if you're missing the marbles, they're like, what, a couple bucks at Walmart for a bag? Problem solved.
Yes, or I just go online and I think I can get pieces for probably 20 bucks.
Yeah.
Found these for 50 cents a piece. These are cool from, I believe, 98, yeah. These Scooby-Doo stickers.
Well, that seems just dandy.
Isn't that awesome? We got the Halloween-themed ones.
I mean, wasn't the whole show Halloween-themed?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. I'm going to be honest with you, and a lot of people give me crap for this. I never liked the show.
Oh, I love the show.
It was just one of those. I never got into it. Like, I never hated it enough to change it, but I never was like, oh my god, Scooby-Doo's on. Never, ever. Like,
I watched it with my mom when I was a kid, so I think there's sentimental value there. But
yeah, I can see that.
And the imagery's great.
Yeah, I always love the animation and the sound effects. The show itself, I just never find myself getting into.
This blew my mind, too. I found some vinyl this week, and that almost never happens. We found this early In Excess record. Shaboom, Shaboom. Shabba, Shabba, whatever it's called. Solid record. I don't know a lot about it, obviously, or I'd say something, but it's In Excess, and I like In Excess.
Yeah, there you go.
And this band, I couldn't believe I found this record. It was by itself. There was no other records around it. And this is probably in my top five favorite bands currently, and it has been for a while, for the last couple of years, and that is The Pains of Being Pure at Heart. Not an easy record to find either on top of that. This will go anywhere from 30 to 50 bucks.
Well, there you go. I have nothing to say about it. I've never even heard of them, to be honest.
I know, but it's weird. You just put it out there. You put the energy out that you love something, and all of a sudden, it comes right at you.
It comes straight to you.
And then I found that, and then on eBay, I went and picked up one of their 7-inches.
Yeah?
Just because I felt in the mood. Another thrifting find for $3. I got this Mario or this Club Nintendo button set.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I got one over there from Richard Brian Kahn in a trade, but this one's in way better condition, and so I'll probably end up holding on to this one and trading the one that I got from Richard Brian Kahn.
I like them. I always thought it was cool.
Club Nintendo, did you ever order anything?
Nope, I redeemed all my stuff and I just never really saw anything, and then I forgot about it, and then I lost everything because it's not a thing anymore. Whoops. I have like probably at least 20 or 30 Wii U games on there. I just never, I don't know. I always looked and I'm like, something will come out eventually, and I just forgot it was a thing when I packed my Wii U away and just never looked at it.
I thought the idea was really neat that they would reward their customers, like the loyalty thing. I ordered a couple things. They had Smash Bros. Posters.
Yeah.
The 3 set, I still have that.
Those are cool.
The DS case I ordered. And there might have been one other thing. And obviously I didn't order this, but, you know, come across two of them.
Yeah, why not? I mean, they're awesome. And who doesn't love pins?
All right, got a package in the mail.
From who?
From eBay.
Oh, okay, that's a good person.
So I think I know what this is.
Yeah, eBay's a very popular person.
Yep. You know, you get in the mood where you're just like, why don't I have that in my life?
Yeah.
And you're like, I need to change this real quick.
Yeah, I do that every time I'm looking at Warhammer stuff. I'm like, why don't I have you? And then I bring it out and it's like $800. I'm like, yeah.
Yeah, that's why. Well, this was more like, I don't know, $7.
Is this something to go with the alien stuff we had before?
No.
Oh.
No, this is the Dead Rising 2 Collector's Edition strategy guide.
Oh, there you go.
It has its map. I know you don't love this game.
Yeah, it wasn't a huge... The only reason I didn't like it was the whole time thing where you had to keep going back to...
Oh, I love that.
And I was like, ugh. Like, every time I'd be doing something, they're like, oh, she's gonna die soon. I'm like, oh my god, just die already, Jesus.
See, I loved it. I loved it, and I can't wait to replay it with that this time and see if it's a little easier. For a couple bucks, I found this Hello Kitty 3DS holder.
Yeah, why not, right?
I mean, anytime you see a 3DS holder that's cross-branded, you know, you can't go wrong.
Are you sure?
Tell me that's not awesome. Like, as far as shelf candy goes, look at that. It's like peach was meant to be right next to it.
I guess so.
I found this. I bought this on a whim. God. This Bakugan. It's got... What is it? What are these little battlers? It's a battle pack.
Never played it. I don't even really know what it is. I just know the little ball things go boop and pop up in the monsters.
That's exactly what it is. I don't know anything about it, so maybe you guys out there know a little bit more. This is from, I believe, 2007. Yes.
Yep.
It's pretty hefty, too. Feel how heavy that is.
Jesus.
I mean, it looks...
Have you opened them to play with them?
Yeah, don't. It's so hard to get them back in because they do pop open. Limited run games. I did a blind box.
They have blind boxes?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't even know that.
So the first blind box I opened up, it's not in there. Because I already traded it to Baseline Ben.
What was it?
Night Trap.
Ah, yep.
I'm like, the one fucking game I didn't need was Night Trap.
You bought the collector's edition?
No, I have a standard edition as well, so.
Okay.
But the other blind box was something I actually needed. That's Reverent Saga.
Ooh, there you go. So when I didn't even hear about blind boxes.
This was around Christmas. I've been waiting on this. So it was quite a while. It's a cool little box they put it in.
I was gonna say, I wish
they put a random card.
I love that company that came out. So instead of limited run games, it's like, what was it? Super
strictly limited, or
yeah, something like that. And they're doing the same thing, but with other games, limited run hasn't done. And I was like, oh my god, this is it, guys.
Well, there's like 5 different companies doing it.
I know, I can't do it.
And I fucked up and ordered a second one of Thea, The Awakening, somehow, some way. Strategy. If you're interested, we could work some deal. I was thinking you when I was like, this
might
be perfect.
Yeah.
So that was my experience with the limited run.
Yeah, I mean both those games. I mean even Night Trap isn't too bad for a blind pick. I mean you just
had but I paid $25 for it, so it wasn't. I saved like $5. I won't do it again. That's it. That is the last blind box.
See, I don't own any limited runs, so I would totally just buy like four or five of them and just be like, yeah, what happens, happens, man.
Yeah, yeah. Oh.
Excuse me.
Oh, and also another limited run game I forgot I ordered was Knights and Bikes on the PS4. This game looks awesome.
It looks like the people from Costume Quest and the creators, no? Oh yeah, Double Fine.
Yeah. Pretty neat one. You can get it obviously on the digital store, but to have a physical copy of it.
It's 1-2. That looks fun.
And the trailer for this, the music is so good.
Yeah, Double Fine usually has good music. I mean, they're in general just a great company.
Went up to Harry and Lloyd's up in Barrie.
Yep.
One of my favorite gaming shops in the world. And I got some stuff resurfaced, and I also got a copy of Dead Rising 2, which I didn't realize I didn't have anymore. I must have traded it years ago after I beat it.
Yeah, and you just got the collectors from Marty.
I did, so now...
Now you have it didn't have the game, right?
No, it didn't have the game.
Oh, problem solved.
Yep, problem solved.
Look at that.
And at GameStop, while I was up there, I found Earth Defense Force 2017, which I didn't have. I didn't even know they made it 2017.
Well, that was released back in like 2000.
Obviously.
6 or 7 or something like that. I know it was like wicked long time ago.
I'd never see this, but this, then again,
this was actually the first one that got me into it. Like, I bought it when it was like $40, and I was like, wow, this is actually really fucking good. And then I told everyone about it, and everyone was like, oh man, and they'd come back and be like, yeah, this game sucks. And now everyone's like, EDF is awesome. I'm like, oh, you guys hated it. Like,
what the fuck? No, it's great. I love it. So that was the last one. I didn't even know about that.
Oh, yeah.
Because I have all the other ones.
It was great. That was the one when I still had a 360. I was looking for that everywhere, but I could only find the other one or two on the system. And I was like, eh, crap. I missed the old one. I think it's good.
Oh, this was cool. Out thrifting. I found from 1988 this Woody Woodpecker pencil topper.
I was gonna say, I hope that's not you bought a pencil. Okay, that's just
found a couple old school wrestlers here. I got a collection over there, but
yeah,
I did not have Jesse the Body Ventura.
That's he looks so dead. See, every time I think of him, I just think of him in Predator. That's all I think of.
Yeah, that's a good thing. And
I don't even know who that is. I'm not a wrestling guy, so I don't know.
It's Nikolai Volkov. I already have one of him over there, so this is a double. But for 50 cents, I wasn't going to leave him behind.
Nope.
Whoa. Wait a minute here. So, the website, what is it? Mercari? It's kind of like eBay.
Oh, I've never even heard of it.
I've heard of it. I never dealt with it because I'm like, I don't know about this. It's it seems a little sketchy. But I was like, fuck it, let's go for the sketchy because I'm willing to try something once and see how it goes.
Yeah.
I've had my eye on trying to get the collector's edition for Bravely Default for a while.
I had that when it originally came out, and I was sad. I dropped it and it got banged up when I was moving. The corners got obliterated, and then someone offered me retail for it a year or so later, and I was like, fine, just get it out of my face.
Well, this seller had both of them, Bravely Default and Bravely Second, for $105.
Each or total?
Total.
Holy crap.
And then I see that it's been shipped. I go to my mailbox and check, and they sent it separate. So one shipping was like $10 and one was $12. And it was in a fucking bubble mailer.
Oh, God.
Yeah, so as you can see,
yeah,
unfortunately, in the corner got banged up. But everything else is brand new condition. The game has been played, but...
Oh, Jesus, a bubble mailer?
Yeah.
You said that, and I actually started having a panic attack. I'm like, who would do that?
And obviously, this was the one I really wanted, this Bravely Default. Yeah,
that one was such a good game, too.
Well, I can't wait to dive into it, because if it plays anything like Octopath Traveler, I'm gonna love it. I think it's the same people.
Yeah, I was gonna say, Square Enix.
So there it is. I got those 105 off that website, and I feel good about it. So I did another order. But we're going to have to wait a couple weeks for that to come.
The only way you could ship these worse. I bought a board game one time off Facebook. Made a deal with someone. And I got it in the mail. And if this was the board game, he took it, slapped the shipping label on it, and then put tape on the sides to hold it. So when I got it from the thing, it was all banged up. And I was like, oh my god.
They used the box to ship it.
They used the actual box to ship it. And when I was like, bro, what did you do? He's like, oh, that's fine. I'm like, not really. Like, it's completely destroyed. Like, packing tape on the box. Like, I ended up throwing it out and just buying a new one. I was like, I can't. Like, I opened it and there were pieces missing. And I was like, bro, you said this was like brand new and stuff. He's like, yeah, it was. I'm like, well, you're missing these pieces. He's like, no, it must have fell out during shipping. I'm like, because it's not in a box. So, yeah, it might have. It
very well could have. That would have been much worse. I'm glad. Yeah. Like I said, the price, at that price.
Yeah, for both of them?
For both of them. Because for the Bravely Default alone, I think the bottom end you're going to spend is $70.
Yeah.
So, it was like that was pretty much a throw-in. So, we're all good.
Yeah.
We're all good.
That's not bad.
Found some movies. Tales from the Dark Side, the first season.
I have the whole series on DVD. I love Tales of the Dark Side. So good.
Yeah, I feel like I saw this back in the day, but it's been years.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they're so cheesy. They're not scary when you watch them now. You're like, okay, buddy.
But that's the point, right? Real campy. And we also got Hedwig and the Angry Inch.
I don't know anything about music. I know about him. Well, her.
You've seen this before?
I have not seen the movie, but I've heard the music. And my one of my old friends told me about, like, he was listening to him, and I was like, I don't know what this is. And he's like, it's Hedwig and the Angry Inch. And he literally explained, like, the whole thing. And I was like, no shit, dude. So when people bring up all these obscure things, I'm like, I don't know that. But when I see that, I'm like, I'm going to say I know that.
Yeah, so it's a neat cult film. You know, I remember when it came out. Must have been 97, 96, 97, 98, somewhere in there, because I was still in high school, and I enjoyed it, so yeah. Now we got it again.
That's awesome.
Oh, Baseline Ben, I traded him my copy of Night Trap for another copy of Mercenary Saga.
I did want that off you.
Oh, my copy's still sealed. See, that there was my dilemma.
Oh, yeah, I'll just buy that one then.
Either way, I was like, I'd much rather have this than Night Trap, because this is kind of hard to come by.
Yeah.
It's the price is like rocketing on it, so I was like, I have a sealed copy. I really don't want to open it if it's just going to keep going up.
That is true.
Another DVD, The Last Unicorn.
I used to cry. I can't even watch that movie because when I was a little kid, I'd cry all the time. I don't even remember at what part. I just remember I hate that movie because I cried a bunch.
Well, maybe I can watch it tonight and cry.
There you go. It was a good movie, though.
Found a copy of Madden 20 for $5. Out hunting. I mean, the trade will trade in for $12 right now.
Oh, yeah, that's okay.
So I'm just going to hold on to it, play it a little bit more, because I enjoyed it when I bought it right out the gate, and I traded it in at the highest point. So now we still got a couple more months before this thing tanks to nothing.
Yeah. I used to love those people working at GameStop who'd come in with like Madden 08, 9, 10, 11, and 12. You're like, what do you mean it's only 30 cents? I paid $60. And I'm like,
Fucking 4 years ago.
Good for you, man, yeah.
We got this audiobook, The Colorado Kid. It's a Stephen King story. I don't know this one, but it's always fun in the car if you have something to throw in, especially if you're night driving.
Oh, yeah. I always listen to H.P. Lovecraft stories sometimes on long rides.
Fun, right? Yeah, it is spooky. Yeah, it's all dark on the highway, especially you get into Vermont, New Hampshire.
Oh, yeah, it gets all foggy and stuff, and you're like, if my car breaks, I'm just going to kill myself. I ain't dealing with this shit.
Found a bunch of CDs, a ton. We're going to buzz right through these. And the classic, you give me the yay or nay if you've heard of them.
Okay.
First up, we got the Best of Cinderella.
Heard of them.
We got Bane, Give Blood.
Nope.
Hardcore band Boston. We got Tesla.
Maybe. They sound familiar. But not because of the car.
Kid Creole and the Coconuts.
No.
We got Apes. Ghost Games.
No.
Alright. We got Wasp. The Sting. We got a cassette tape, The Talking Heads, Remain in Light.
No.
No? A Burlington band from the 90s, Dysfunction. Vermont Pride right there. I was pumped to find that one. American Graffiti, soundtrack. You've never seen American Graffiti.
No,
you
haven't.
Son of a bitch.
Yeah, no, I was like, you said soundtrack, it's like, I'm screwed.
Filter.
Yeah.
Is this the first album? I don't know. I feel like the first album's kind of alright. Could be wrong. We got a bunch more. Less Than Jake.
Heard of him.
In With the Out Crowd. Kind of a collector's edition booklet there. We got Pete Townsend.
Heard of him.
Say Anything.
Heard of him.
It's going to Jordan. The Best of Midnight Oil.
Nope.
Cake.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Bobby McFerrin.
No.
Don't Worry, Be Happy.
Okay, yeah.
Spice Girls.
No. Just kidding.
What the fuck? Bjork.
Yes.
Outkast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the one with the whole world. I like that song.
No, it is not. Tsunami Bomb.
No.
Punk band from California. Good stuff.
Probably why.
Against Me.
Yeah, that sounds really familiar. I think so.
Yeah. We got this Punks Unite Leaders of Today. It's a compilation, so that doesn't really count. The soundtrack for Office Space.
Yeah.
That's a fun movie.
Oh, yeah. I love that movie.
Sean Kingston. You don't remember that song, Beautiful Girls? You probably do. Oh, I found a couple Dreamcast games randomly buried in the mix of CDs, too, when I was out hunting.
Oh, there you go.
I found this Tony Hawk Pro Skater. It's missing the front cover, but it has the back. And also Blitz 2000.
Oh, I love the Blitz.
Blitz is so much fun.
The other night I had a dream I was collecting Dreamcast games. When I woke up, I was like, I should collect Dreamcast games. They don't get enough love for what they were at the time, to be honest. They were miles better than PS2.
So good.
I had a dream. Only kid I knew in a high school with a Dreamcast. And I remember I was so upset because I had a Dreamcast. Had it for like 3 months. And then next thing I know, all the games are like $5 on clearance. And I was like, what? And then I bought as many as I could. By the, like, couple months later, all my controllers broke. Could never find another. So I had all these games I never played.
And where did you buy the games from?
KB Toys.
That's right, because I was working there when we had those.
Yep, I don't know if it was you, but I remember I went in really young with my mom, and I was like, it was like buy one, get one free, yeah, on like all the games, and I was like, I want Machin X, Zombies Revenge, Sonic's Adventure, and Time something.
Time Stalkers.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah.
All four of those right in one go, because they were like $5 to $10 each, and I was like, boom, boom, boom.
To go back in time with the knowledge now, because I bought the system brand new for $30, because when River City Rebels first got signed, we got our van, we had a TV in there. I bought the Dreamcast, we put it in the van to tour with, and we bought, you know, I had like a handful of games. I think the UFC game, unfortunately, just because it was so quick, was probably the one that got played the most.
Power Stone? Oh, I loved Power Stone.
Yeah, see, but very cool, and it's nice to find them every once in a while.
Oh, yeah.
I maybe add one per year to my collection.
Yeah, and the catalog's not huge.
No, it but it's expensive. Yeah. It's really fucking expensive.
Yeah.
This is all right. We found another audio book, and that is Larry Bird and Irving Magic Johnson. There's a movie, there's a book, and this is obviously the audio book. And it'll go up with my Larry Bird collection up there, because I love him so much.
Well, there you go.
We've got some more DVDs. We got Dice Rules Untamed.
With Andrew Dice Clay.
Yeah. That's awesome. We got Slapstick. A reunion show. This was a ska band from the late 90s.
Oh, okay.
Chicago, real good stuff. And I found the first season of Bleach for $2.
Hmm.
I mean, for $2.
Yeah, for $2, you can't go wrong.
I wasn't going to leave that. Picked up some VHS. We found Novocaine, starring Steve Martin.
Yeah, never heard of it, but okay. I love Steve Martin.
Waking Ned Divine. And the Defiant Ones.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's from the 50s.
Oh, okay.
Sidney Poitier and Tony Curtis. Hmm. So it looks fun.
Man, this was a huge pickup. Do you have any more?
I feel like I do. Oh, yep.
We do.
I found a couple buttons.
Okay, I could kind of dig those, yeah.
What's game night? Is that...
Oh, Star City Games. So, Star City Games every Friday has Friday Night Magic the Gathering. And it's hosted at every local game store that qualifies for it. And you get pins and t-shirts and stuff like that depending on certain things and stuff. So that's really all it is just a Magic the Gathering thing.
Alright, so that's pretty neat, though.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know if they're worth anything, but everyone loves a creature collection.
Yeah, so. To me, it was 50 cents. I like buttons, yeah. So for 50 cents...
Yeah, can't go wrong, really.
That is the pickup.
That was a huge pickup.
It was. It was a lot of stuff, and the sad part is this is only like a third of the stuff that I have to get through eventually. But we're obviously gonna stretch it, because last week was kind of slow. I didn't find a ton. This stuff is from more or less...
A couple
weeks ago, so I'm trying to catch up now.
Yeah, wow.
But we're adding some really good collector's edition stuff, which is exciting.
Yeah, like those are amazing. I just love the way they look. And the art, oh, get out of here.
Yeah, and I have the game, so I'm going to,
Yeah, just leave that on display. Be like... play the game or whatever.
Yeah, or I have the loose game, so I'm going to try to flip those and try to recoup some of my $105.
Oh, easy. You can easy. Bravely Default was fantastic.
Yeah, I think number two, unfortunately, is like a $8 game now.
Yeah, I was going to say, Bravely Second, I bought at full retail, and then like 3 weeks later, I was like, I have made a huge mistake watching the price on this game.
But the first one, I think, still holds around that $20 mark, yeah. So that's kind of cool.
Yeah, I don't know what was wrong with the second. I never played it. I bought it at full retail and just ended up trading it later to someone for some stuff, and I was like, eh.
So,
damn.
Yeah, that's about it. You've been playing some video games? What are you...
I've been playing a lot of Apex Legends again lately. Like, a lot. Like, too much.
Doesn't it suck when one game like that takes up your time?
Yeah, because...
there's no story there.
No, and aside from what me and Jordan record, I haven't played anything in a while. I did try to play The Sinking City, the Call of Cthulhu game. And after, like, 2 hours just doing the tutorial and detective work, I was like, man, this game sure does is a game. And I just ejected, never played it again. I was thinking it was like Resident Evil 4 with Cthulhu stuff, but they're like, no, it's super heavy detective work. I'm like, I don't want that.
I don't
want
to think, goddammit.
I know,
damn it.
Like, you give me all these guns and stuff, I don't want to think and do that. I just want to, like, that's why I play Apex. Because I just literally fly down and...
Yeah,
whatever.
No, it's brainless. It's kind of like, I've been playing that 2-point hospital.
Oh yeah, yep.
Which is a blast. I mean, there's some thinking going on, but it's, you can't really fuck up.
Yeah, it's just,
If you fuck up, you just fix it and, you get around the problem that way. But it's mindless. You can play it at 3 in the morning with no sound on and still have a good time with it.
See, that's what I do with The Sims. I would invite my girlfriend over. My wife would get mad. I'd fix it by putting my wife in the pool, deleting the ladder, and be like, problem solved. Let's move on, everyone. Like, it's probably, whatever.
Did you download
Sims 4?
4?
Oh, yeah.
It's weird. I fired it up, and I'm not loving it as much as... Something is not there that once was.
It doesn't feel like The Sims.
It does.
Or something. I play it and I'm like, eh. I actually loaded The Sims 3 on my computer shortly, a couple days after that, and I was like, this feels like The Sims. I don't know what the hell 4 was. Like, even just making a character, I was like, man, I'm not feeling this.
Yeah, it's funny you say that. That's really right off the gate, and I wasn't loving it. It wasn't like Sims busting out on the GBA.
Oh, God.
I beat that son of a bitch.
Those were great games. Like, I have The Sims 3 with every pack of DLC. Because one time I just logged on just during the Steam sale, and they were like, hey man, $120 for everything. And I was like, okay, and I bought it. And my girlfriend was like, you're never going to play it. And I was like, but if I do, I have it.
It's right there.
Sure enough, she was right 5 years later. I still have not played it that much. Maybe 40 hours at most.
Well, I think that sums it up right there. This is a long episode. Yeah. Thank you very much for hanging out with us.
Lovely as always.
And we'll be back at it next week. And until then, do what you do and
toodaloo. Bye.
Oh.